Hey everybody, my name is Jay Martin. Thanks for watching. What I wanted to do is put a little video together with some tips on how to use the melee infantry with the Ottoman army. And I did this after I did the video for Point Mana. Some people posted some comments like, hey, that was kind of interesting. Give me some tips. And let me say, first of all, I'm not the expert on this. You'd want to talk to like maybe Point himself or Riskguard, who I know plays Ottomans a lot, to get some tips on it. But I'm going to share with you what I know and the way to use the Ottoman melee units to their most effective. And what I'm going to try to do is cut two games together. I played a handful of games using this tactic, and I'm going to try to splice them together in a reasonable amount of time just to show you how the assaults go down. First thing, let's talk about the types of units you have available to you. There are two general units that you have. The first is the Bashi Bazooka right there. These guys are super cheap. They're like $250. They're really fucking cheap. The second unit is the Semit Janissary, which is kind of like the more legit, more expensive unit. They both have their pros and cons. The pro of the Bazooka is that it is A, very, very cheap, and B, putting the chevrons on it are really easy and everything. And bazookas have a huge advantage in that they have, like, resistance to fatigue or something like that. So you can run them a long way. Like, if you're playing on the Pyramids map on the hillside, you can run them up to the top of the hill, and they have really good fatigue resistance. So bazookas are really nice because you can run them around kind of like Cav and still get some decent performance out of them. The second kind of unit is the Semit Janissary. Now, Semit Janissary is the real deal. These are bad boys. These guys, you put a couple chevrons on them, they can take down an old guard. And they hit really hard, but they're a little more expensive. And the downside of Janissary is that they get tired really easy, kind of like heavy cav. A really good analogy would be light cav and heavy cav. These guys hit really hard, but they're more expensive. They get tired more easily. So those are kind of your two options. Most people just blindly play Semit Janissaries. I think that's a mistake. In a lot of games, bazookas are what you want to use. Like on the Pyramids map, I don't use the Janissaries. I only use bazookas. So the two different units kind of have different roles. They serve different purposes. You'll notice in this game that I'm playing, I'm walking up. And the whole reason I'm walking my army up is I want to keep my Semit Janissaries fresh. I can't run them. If I was only playing bazookas, then I could run them. Another thing, okay, so those are the types of units you have. General principle, you need to give these guys experience. Putting chevrons on these units really pays dividends. You can see I've got like 5 or 6 on that guy, I've got 4 and everybody else, I've got a bunch on that guy. And I also have the best general as Ottomans. Now, this is a matter of personal taste, and you'll find a comfort zone that you have, but you really want to add some combination of chevrons and the unique generals to using your melee units, okay? You're really going to want to buff their stats a little bit, okay? So that's kind of how to use the units. The second conceptual thing to think about is kind of the role that melee units play in your army. And they work... I don't know, there's two ways to explain this theoretically. The first is maybe they adopt the role of pseudo-light infantry, or B, they adopt a role of pseudo-cav. I tend towards B, that they adopt a role of pseudo-cav in your army, and the way you want to use them, you have to use them in conjunction with the rest of your army. What you want to do, get your line infantry up there shooting at them, and then charge your Janissaries, and hopefully you'll have cav to help out. When your Janissaries are engaged in combat, in melee combat, the unit they're engaging will not be able to fire. They won't be able to shoot, which means that your line infantry, if you have it behind there, will be shooting. So you get a really great 1-2 punch. You get the hit from the Janissaries backed up by the fire from your line infantry. So that's how you want to use them. You want to use them in conjunction with the rest of your army. If you can get cav in there, that's great. Alright, so that's kind of the conceptual thing, and you can see that this game is developing right now. We're getting pretty close to our opponent. I'm going to cut out right now, and I'm going to pick you back up when the engagement starts and show you how I use the infantry in this particular game. Okay, so picking back up the action, you notice that I've moved my line infantry in range of his lights, and I'm engaging them to shoot. One thing that I didn't do very well in this particular game, but that you want to do when you're playing melee infantry, is you have to time everything really quickly. You want your melee guys to show up to get engaged at about the same time. I kind of fucked this up. I should have been a little slower on how I do it. Now, here's the second thing. I'm going to hold the spacebar down. You can see that I'm sending my bazookas in, and I'm targeting my bazookas at all at separate units. You don't want to bunch your melee units up into a big ball. I see a lot of people do that. Don't do that. You want to target them at separate units, and at this point, you want to get them in there at a run. Sorry, I'm moving the camera around too much. Let me find a good spot. So you want to get them in there at a run, and you want to get them in there to attack. Now, here comes the attack. It's kind of fun to watch. Go, bazookas! And there they go. Now, what you'll notice is that that unit that I just charged can't shoot anymore, so my unit is shooting. This guy's making a side tactical mistake. His lights are shooting into the backs of his own line. But you can see that my guys get in there. Now, we actually won that one. Our bazookas routed there. That's fine, because our bazookas took fire from two units of line infantry in reserve. That's fine. Bazookas, in a certain way, are kind of like meat shields. I mean, they're so fucking cheap, you can just throw them in. If they die, they die. But they cause some havoc. Now, here come the big boy Semit Janissaries. The unit that guy was targeting already routed, so we changed targets over here. And these Semit Janissaries are going to get in. It's the same general principle. Line infantry goes in. Line infantry takes the hit. Send the Janissaries in behind them. And then you move your line infantry up behind them to engage the enemy. So what's happening right now is my Janissaries are fucking up his infantry. And my line guys move behind to put some shots in him. Now, a purist would argue that it's not ideal because my line units there will be shooting my guys in the back a little bit. That is true. However, that's kind of a fact of life. You're going to take a few casualties that way. The one thing you do want to avoid is don't charge cav into the back of your melee units. Look, they just did a great job cleaning up those units. I'm going to send them after these foot guards now. Don't charge cav from the same vector or the same direction. So charging cav from this area here will kill a lot of my own men. If you are going to support with a cav charge, you want to come from the back side of your unit. That tactic is called a hammer and anvil. It's actually kind of hard to put together in Napoleon, but that's what you want to do. That was probably a mistake for me because my second unit is going to charge into the back of my first unit, so that was not ideal. You really want to engage your melee units one at a time is what you really want to do. Just keep them. Do not ball them like I did right there. You want to engage them one at a time at individual units. That's a bazooka that came back from routing thanks to the 9-star general. And I actually do pull off hammer and anvil here. I get a cav unit in the rear of that unit. I have the melee in the front of that unit, and I have my own guy shooting at him in the back. So that's a kind of a good way to use them. There you go. So the conceptual tips from this particular game were put chevrons on them, and you want to use them as kind of a sort of a pseudo cav force. Get your line infantry in there first, and then move your melee. A third thing that I'll note is that a lot of times when you bring these melee builds, you don't bring light infantry because they're kind of useless. You just line infantry are generally better at shooting. They have more men in them. So you want to ignore lights. Just use your line and your melee, which kind of take the role of your lights. So that was game number one, and let me catch you up in game number two. Okay, this is the second game, and first thing, well, I'm looking at this from my opponent's perspective, who is camping in the corner and actually doing a pretty damn good job of it, by the way. This is one of the better examples of corner camping I've ever seen. But what I wanted to do before the action started is give you a rundown on how you kind of like your army build should look. I think, again, not the expert, but you want about 8 line infantry. 8 line infantry are enough to kind of control the length of the map or to stretch a good portion of the map so you can always have firepower when you want it. And then if you have a general, which I really recommend, that's 9, so that would leave you 11 slots left. And so that could be like 6 melee, 5 cav, or 6 cav, 5 melee, or some combination of that. But really, I think you want to have about 8 line. In some situations, like in pyramids, the build I bring, I only use 6 line. but I bring a lot of extra cav on that because I want to be able to move really fast. So you want to have, just from a default, you know, let's try, you know, 8 line, 6 melee, 5 cav, something like that. What's going on here is, on the left, I have Janissaries, and I think I start my assault, and notice that I've targeted my Janissaries each at a separate unit. And then I move all my cav over to this unit here, and I think I'm gonna retarget my cav going to a different unit. Oh, those are bazookas, sorry. So bazookas hit. And I want to give you a little tip, and I think I changed targets here because he retreats his lights. Over here, the same thing has happened. Notice my Janissaries are all hitting a separate unit, and I did run all my cav into the same unit. That's kind of a waste, but I didn't have a lot of space here. He had staked up the center of the line. So the way I do it is you move your line of tree to get shoot, and then your Janissaries move in for the melee. Man, that's cool looking. Look at that. This guy was the host. It was on ultra settings, and I break my cav through and change him to target the general. Back over here, kind of the same general thing is happening. Look, we're even routing people, and we're getting in there, and we're doing pretty good. And again, it's the same formula. You get in there with your melee, your shooter guys are behind them, and then I have a reserve cav unit that's coming in to chase down these units here that are still remaining. So that is the general way that you want to play with your melee infantry. You can't send, and he rage quits right here, but you can't send your melee guys alone. They have to be, like, it has to be a coordinated effort. But if you do coordinate that effort, you can do some really fucking cool things. And it's actually a really fun. It's a really fun strategy or tactic to use because it's just so different than everything else you do in this game. So, you know, give the Ottomans a try. You know, try the different styles of melee units and just see what happens. Just have a good time with it. But use them intelligently, you know. Back up your line with them. Do that kind of thing. So anyway, hey, thanks again for watching. I hope that helps. If you have any more questions about this issue, leave me a comment, and maybe I could follow up with a second video or something like that. I'm sure I left a few things unanswered. So anyway, again, thanks for watching. More information at tdreplays.com.